This is bad.
Why am I doing this? What's good, everyone? Welcome back. It's Fanafra, and today I'm playing a Shadow Over Freddy's. My one friend, you may know him from a couple of my other videos, Coda. He's wanted me to play this fucking game for so long. He wants me to record it. Oh my god. Okay. Well, let's get started. Right now I got bacon with me, so. Oh, it while I play a game. Should I read this? I'll read it. It's gonna be on a voice changer, so hold on.
You wake up in a small dark room, laying down on a cold checkered floor with your back against a wall, feeling like hell. Your mouth tastes like copper and there's nothing to hear but the low buzz of a metal fan. Gradually your eyes begin to open, muscles still trembling as they try to stretch out, stretch and contract. Your memory is foggy and your head throbs, failing to recall any information that might shed light on your current situation. Your body reacts faster than your brain, picking itself up off the floor using the desk nearby. You grab a light source and begin to look around to regain your bearings. A lifeless husk of a building reveals itself to you through the cone of a flashlight. Dust and cobwebs lining every corner, crumbled up papers, cups and black stains covering the floor, drips of water seeping through the rotten wooden ceiling. The layout's familiar to you, but its walls aren't nearly as inviting or friendly. Your chest feels heavy with dread, much like a man being to be hung at the gallows. The first coherent thought that enters your head urges you to leave as soon as possible. Leave immediately, before the shadows have devoured this abandoned building. No, the shadows that have devoured this abandoned building come to consume you as well. Welcome to Freddy Fazbear's Pizza. It's great to have you home. 5 nights remaining.
Okay. So before this really gets started, I've already kind of played this game. I've played like night 1 and night 2, but after that I like stopped playing because this game just had me like on the edge. Okay. Yeah. Hostile presence is watching, 46 AM, you will be attacked, and let's go. Now this is where the game begins. Find the exit. Okay. So in night 1, does anything that's actually like attack you in night 1?
No.
I don't remember. I don't think so. Did the door just fucking close?
Yeah.
Yo. That never happened before. Can't forget that I need to use sound to actually like listen and shit. I mean, nothing over here. There's nothing. It's just ambience. A whole lot of ambulance? So Chelsea just drawled with Bournemouth. Man, Chelsea's really sucking, huh? Oh, exit. Mm-hmm. Now this is exactly where the game truly begins. I swear this was a lot closer. To go for like the actual exit now. Pretty sure this isn't the end of night 1. This is not the end of night 1. They just restarted, right? Yep, you're pulled back to safety by a floating, featureless figure standing before you with its eyes locked in your pale face. It looks like it wants to help recover your lost memories. The shadow offers you a story to clear your head. Would you accept? Yes. Now from what I know in this game, I think there's a good ending. I know like most of the game. Because I did watch like videos on this, kind of, not really.
There once was a little kid who liked to play with toys by his lonesome. He lived with his family on a small peaceful house outside of the town surrounded by forest. In the home's backyard was his personal stage where he played with his figurines of various shapes and sizes, making plays which were acted out for his enjoyment alone. Although he was alone, he was content in living out his youth playing with the plastic friends his parents had gifted him. They were a small mannequin, a stuffed teddy bear, a porcelain dressed up doll and a toy robot. One day, the family's pet dog stole one of the toys during his playtime. Into the woods, he excitedly ran away with the toy robot, prompting the kid to chase after him to reclaim his friend. Annoyed by the dog's playful attitude, the kid caught up, grabbing the toy from the thief's mouth. He began to pull. Oh, to be young and carefree. A kid and his dog playing tug-of-war in the backyard of the garden. Back in the garden of the house. No one's interrupted. Seems like a wonderful memory, doesn't it? The dog, excited to finally receive attention it craved for the young master of the house, refused to lose the game they found themselves playing. The toy robot was almost free from the dog's mouth when...
This is bad!
Relieved to have gotten his friend back, the kid wiped off the pull and drew off the toy robot with the bottom of his shirt. He walked back home, leaving the animal twitching helplessly on the grass, with barely enough room left in its swollen neck to let out a pitiful dry howl. The kid, arriving back out from the trees, positioned the toy robot back where it was on his makeshift stage and continued playing. Later that afternoon, the parents found the body of the dog. They buried it where it stood.
So relatable. 4 nights remaining. Oh, we just go to night 2? Oh, that is night, so that was night 1.
Stupid!
Okay, well, now you know what I'm getting myself into.
Oh my fucking god, this is about to be fucking...
This is about to be pain. Did you know your enemies become more aggressive? A new presence has appeared in the restaurant. It hides in rooms waiting for you to pass by. Be careful where you're going. Where do I go? I'm gonna go left. Follow the music. Oh, the music goes to the bathroom. Oh,
stupid!
Fuck. Son of a bitch. Okay, so I have to, like, walk straight, like, right now. Okay, my bad. Don't close the door. Motherfucker. That's just ambience. A lot of it. Bucks. I keep looking at like my TV. Oh, just walk that way. This ambience is low-key, like, just annoying. Ain't nothing else. I didn't hear any other noises besides the music box. Although I saw flashing. Hold on. Definitely over here. What was that? I heard something. What was that? Nothing. Nothing. What? I'm just gonna walk down. What? Okay. Whoa. Let's just walk up there. Fuck it. Running down. Okay. No, it's just back here. It's down here, yeah. It's in the bathroom. Okay, come on, just go in. Running. Okay, now I have to find it again. Nothing, but this music box is this way. Okay. Whoa, what the fuck? Where? I'm gonna go this way. I don't literally hear nothing else. I'm just gonna go this way. No way. It is just in the middle of the fucking pizzeria? Just walk down. What's that way? Wait, which way? It sounds more this way. Let's go this way. What's that? It's down there. Oh yeah, just go down here. Run it down quickly. How many more times do I have to find it? I hear it down there. Nothing? I don't hear any of it. Okay, just go down. Oh, it's down here. Yeah. Go. It's 3 a.m.? in the backstage. Easy. Epic. More bacon. You're pulled back again to safety as the sounds of the untuned music box wind down. The silent offers another story of a war for completing your task. Will you accept? Might as well.
This story, is, I tell you, is a true story that I pray you never forget. There once was a boy laid awake at night during a harsh downpour. Beneath the covers of his bed, he closed his eyes and tried to ignore the storm just outside his room. Enveloped in the darkness, a sensation of creeping discomfort kept him from falling asleep. The roars of the storm were nothing compared to the relentlessness that the shadows cast from the window gave him. He felt eyes watching him from afar. The boy opened his eyes and looked towards the window, but nothing was there. He tried to go back to sleep.
Why did that startle me?
Really, nigga?
He opened his eyes again, and out of the corner of his eye, he spotted it. The hollow, white eyes of a living shadow. It appeared just as quickly as it went away. His uneasiness pushed it aside. By growing curiosity, the boy got from his bed and approached the window. From out the glass, you could see it. The silhouette of an animal, darker than the night around it, and the void of the color, even when light struck its frame, running off the trees with a familiar object stuck in its mouth. His favorite toy, stolen again, being carried to the forest. The boy couldn't help but follow along the shadow's path.
Oh my god. Okay.
The night air was freezing. Brazen winds carrying countless droplets that hit the skin like marbles, their impact deafening any other sound other than the imposing thunder. Call it premonition. I definitely butchered that. But he knew where the shadow has gone to. The place at the edge of the forest where he had left the family dog. He was sure he would find it. Standing in front of the grave once more, the eyes from the shadow had gone away. And instead, the twice stolen robot toy now lay on top of the muddy mound. But this time, it was moving. Its tiny plastic arms flailing violently from side to side, its head rotating in place. The movements were sudden, but clear, unprompted by any outside influence. A spark of life was trapped inside this tiny vessel. Fascinated by such discovery, he picked up the toy from the ground and held it tightly with both of his hands to prevent it from escaping his grasp. Smiling from ear to ear, the boy headed back home.
Oh my god, and now there are 3 nights remaining.
Oh my god, bro, I gotta like mentally prepare myself for this game. Oh my god.
Okay, what's poppin'? What are we doing? Oh, don't stand still. Enemies will move into your room if you take too long hiding next to you. A new presence, it moves slower, but it's hard to detect. Be patient when leaning over onto other rooms. I don't even know what I do here. Okay, what am I supposed to do? What's the objective? Enter the kitchen. Okay. That's easier said than done. Wait, do I have to find a key? Don't tell me I have to find keys. Don't tell me I have to find keys. Oh my god, I have to find the keys. Oh, but I found a Chica doll. So I gotta move quickly. Okay. Move around. I don't know where I'm supposed to find this key, so I'm just gonna walk around until I find it. Wait a minute.
This is bad! This is very, Steven very bad!
Jesus Christ. That was terrible. That was really bad. That was awful. Oh my god. That is the worst jump scare I've ever fucking experienced in my goddamn life, I swear. I'm assuming, okay, this is the storage room. You'd think the keys would be in here, right? Because it's the storage room. Right? I'm not wrong, right? Please tell me I'm not just stupid.
Stupid! Oh my
fucking god, you're kidding. Just walk down the hall. Ooh, I heard something. What is it? Where? 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 Oh, it's over there. Don't jump scare me. I'm scared. I don't like this game, bro. I should have stayed a bitch. Where? Where is it? Where? Where? Oh my god. Dog. I'm going this way. I don't care. I might just die. I might 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 die. I need to find where the key is. I don't hear anything on either side of that door. Nothing. Look back right, just cause. What? Okay, yeah. Listen for a quick second. Look back. Yeah. Hey, yo. Chill out. I'm gonna go in this room. Go to the back room. No jump scare, please. No jump scare, please. No jump. Keys. Found keys. Okay. I got keys. Okay, find the kitchen. I know where the kitchen is. I know where the kitchen is. Okay. Nothing. Okay, we go this way. My god, bro. Whoa, 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 whoa. Hey. Nothing. Okay, this way, this way, this way, this way. Kitchen. The kitchen's this way. Nothing. Move. Do I get the Chica plush? Let's go get it. Kinda want it. I'm scared. I don't like this, dude. I really hate this. Nothing. Hey. 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 Don't do that. Don't do that. Stop. Don't do that. Stop. Where? Where? I'm scared. Stop. Huh. Oh my god. Thank god, bro. This bacon tastes so much better after that, bro. You'll pull back the safety as the room fades away around you. The shadow offers yet another story from your past. Will you accept? Sure. Yes.
This is the true story that I tell you. I hope you're taking notes for the quiz at the end.
What? A quiz?
There once was a young man who had grown hungry for knowledge, going into adolescence. He had isolated himself from his family, focusing instead on his passion for the unknown, the spiritual, the place of mystery he had come to know years ago. In a box under his bed, he hid his secret away from all the others. Living plastic friend, Still thrashing and writhing inside, each night he observes its movements intensely. The young man spent entire days from home, reading and studying about spirits and vessels. His interest turned into obsession, and he needed to understand. No, his need to understand grew. Alas, it was all for naught, as no book had the key to the answers he'd been seeking. All he found were vague rumors and legends with no instructions or explanations. To continue down the rabbit hole, he knew what had to be done. He looked so fucking out of it, bro. He's like, yeah. Since he was a kid, the young man never saw his dad as any more than an obstacle. He was moody, aggressive, old alcoholic. He only talked to the son when he needed something to shout at. Having driven everyone that loved him away, the drunkard was worth less than nothing in the eyes of the boy. Thus, he was a perfect candidate. One day, when coming home, seeing the old man sprawled onto the kitchen table with a bottle in hand, he decided to show dear old daddy a new way of life. Holding a small felt doll in his right hand, the teen made his way to the house's garage. After a few hours, the deed was done and the plan in action. The boy watched his oblivious father drive away in his car, unaware of the tampering that had been done to the vehicle. Sitting on his bed, the young man took his dear pet out of the box and began to press harshly on its square playhead. As it trembles in pain, he waited on the outcome of his small experiment. Oh. Oh, the humanity. After the car's accident, he recovered the doll that had been planted below the sea and returned to his home. Placing it on the desk, he watched it closely for that same spark that remained inside his robotic friend. But much to his frustration, no movement came from the doll. Nothing. The vessel he had prepared for his father was empty, devoid of even a single ribbon of light. Furious by his failure, he ripped the felt doll apart and threw it aside. What a waste. From then on, he was free on the shackles of his drunken caretaker, but without the trophy he had planned to take from his monstrous act of sabotage. Unflinching in his resolve and with no guilt in his empty heart, he contemplated what to do next.
I wonder who this is all about.
I was kidding when I said there'd be a quiz, by the way. Not that it matters. Or that you deserve it.
There we go. There's the punch. There's the punchline.
2 nights remaining. No more. No more.
No more. Done here. Okay. Forecast to the next night. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, like and subscribe. Comment down below if you want to see more. Just kidding. Don't even comment, bro. I'll still post whatever. Because, like, I gotta play this game. So, I'll see you guys all next time. Goodbye.
Draco undefeated, yeah. Bitch, I'm black and then I'm bleeding. Go long, yeah. These bullets he receive it, I can't see it. My wrist look like a snow cone, make her eat it. Once I see her, I give her that dope dick just like it's eating. Then I leave her.